Hey everyone, I'm Ausome Aidyn and this is my lab. Today we are going to learn about centripetal force. The things we need for this experiment are some rope, a small bucket, some water in the bucket, and a large area where it is okay to get wet. We don't care if we spill water in the lab, so it is perfect. First, tie your rope around the handle on your bucket. If you're having trouble tying it, ask an adult for help. Then fill the bucket about halfway up with water. I'm going to try to tie this thing. Now we are ready to try the experiment. Take the other end of the rope and swing the bucket around in a big circle. Do you think the water will splash out or stay in the bucket? My hypothesis is that it will stay in the bucket.
Are you sure? Did it stay in? Do it again.
None of it spilled out. That's centripetal force in action. Do it one more time.
Okay.
Then we'll get to the sides. What if you repeat the experiment but you swing the bucket slower? Do you think the water will stay in the bucket? Try it at home and let us know how it went in the comments below.
Welcome to Aidyn's Science Park.
Looks like my hypothesis was right, but why? When you flip the bucket around, you cause a force called centripetal force. You might think that the water is being forced to the bottom of the bucket, but they are both being pulled down toward my hand. So when they reach the top, they are both falling at the same speed, so the water stays in the bucket. Another example of this is a satellite orbiting Earth. Gravity is actually pulling the satellite down, just like my hand was pulling the bucket in water. But its forward momentum is faster than the force of gravity, so it orbits instead of falling to the Earth. This is the same with the bucket. Well, that's it for this episode. Be sure to check out our others, and don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, and flip the bell so you will get notified of new videos. Have an awesome day. Goodbye.
Do it. Hold the rope and make the rope longer.